Ted and Jenny Benninger. Her future plans are to attend an undecided college and study nursing. Her most memorable moments, playing in the Hoosier gym and beating Blackhawk Christian in the first game of the regional her sophomore year. Her advice to underclassmen, if you get knocked down, get back up again. Don't let anyone keep you down. Senior Samantha Redinger. And we have Alicia Sarver, also known as Gale. Alicia is the daughter of Eric Sarver and Carrie and Lincoln Osborne. Her future plans are to attend the University of St. Francis and study radiology. Her most memorable moment is dyeing Coach Jennings' hair pink after winning sectionals. Her advice to underclassmen, when in doubt, be a statue. Senior Alicia Sarver.
About Samantha Redinger, obviously, and what she's done this year, but Alicia Sarver has really stepped in and played her role well here as a senior for this team and Coach Jennings.
She's really been confident with the ball in her hands. She can hit that 15-foot jump shot, usually that baseline shot, she's pretty comfortable with. And she's been comfortable in just physicality. Her physicality is just... if she needs to box somebody out and get a rebound, she can do that. She's just somebody that has become a player you can trust at all times on the
right,
floor.
Right, right. Yeah, and, you know, her ball handling has improved quite a bit over the last few years as well. And, you know, not saying that she's going to be the main ball handler, but when they do need, somebody to step up and help out with that, she's been there and done that. So, she's another big piece to this puzzle here for Coach Jennings and this Argus Dragons team here this year. So as they celebrate here, the two seniors, Samantha Redinger and Alicia Sarver, we're going to take a commercial break and come back and get ready. Should be about time for the national anthem and the starting lineups when we get back here on RTC.
Thank you.
a sophomore, number 23, Gabriella Krause. A junior, number 31, Ashley Laster. A sophomore, number 43, Sarah Thompson. A senior, number 45, Maddie Wireman. And a sophomore, number 51, Jayla Patrick. The Lady Bobcats are coached by Aubrey Lady.
So it's going to be Krause, Laster, Thompson, Wireman, and Patrick for the Bobcats. Redinger lead, Barkus, Bullenbacher, wrong team, and Sarver for the Argos Dragons starting us off here tonight. This will be a conference game next year, Val.
Yeah, as if it weren't a rivalry already.
Oh, my gosh, yeah, the history of this, these two teams is just crazy. You talked about maybe off the air there the team that you know, when they won both boys and girls, they had to go through Argos that year to get the girls, and I mean that was a very, very good Argos team that they went through to get that.
Right, that was an Argos team that brought a lot of players back from a team that made it to semi-state in 06. That is Barkus, 3-point try, good by Samantha Redinger. She knew it was in the moment it left her hands. Assist, Barkus. Kick ball out of bounds. It'll be OD ball. See, I know that's John Wright, and I know that's Lou Brown. I don't know who the third official is. I'm not very familiar with him. Krause inbound, and she gets it in to Thompson.
And, you know, one of the things, too, that helps out Morgan Barkus's assist numbers, obviously, when you have Samantha Redinger is going to hit a high percentage of shots, that really helps your assist numbers.
Yeah, I mean, she's. I'd be curious to compare her assist numbers to, say, Courtney Dunlap's. 3-pointer out of the corner is good by Jayla Patrick. And this game is tied 3-3. Lead and Barkus playing catch. 3-point try. Good again. Samantha Redinger.
You'd say normally that's a heat check, but for her, that's just a normal shot. Yeah. She's going to take a lot of those.
But beating the press and scoring on the other end is Laster.
Well, I don't think we're going to have to worry too much about high-pressure defense here tonight.
That's a very good sign for OD that they've broken the press so far. Lead, Bullenbacher, baseline jumper. She hits. Argos is 3-for-3. They lead 8-to-5. But slipping behind the defense and scoring on the other end is Laster again. 8-7.
It's like a Pac-12 game.
Baseline jumper is no good by Redinger. Rebounded by Krause. Stolen from her by Redinger, and the layup is good.
8 points already here for Samantha.
Krause up. Foul on Sarver. Was that active shooting?
I would think so, but looks like they're going to give her to her. They're going to call it on the floor. Is it server or lead? Oh, yep. That was
it was Bollenbacher.
Bollenbacher. Wow, we were both wrong on that one.
Not in the act of shooting.
Well, hold on. Now they put up Sarver's number.
So I thought it was.
Okay. They have two team fouls, so the first foul was on. I don't remember the first foul. They
said yeah, that was on Bolin. Yeah, one on Bollenbacher, one on Sarver.
Okay.
Argos looks like they're in a zone. And that's a turnover. Lead comes away with a loose ball. Again, Lead's got those goalie hands. If she gets her hands on it, she's sticking to them. Missing the shot is Barkas. Put back, no, by Redinger. She's going to the line for two. That's another thing, if you haven't seen Samantha Redinger play a lot, she lives at the foul line. The foul's on Patrick, her first, team's first. I mean, she spends so much time at the foul line, she might have to pay rent, but just as I say that, she misses the first. I think she was 13 for 17 the other night. She does hit the second, 11 to 7. Redinger with 9. Pull-up jumper. Good by Jayla Patrick.
5 now for Patrick. So Laster and Patrick, the two scorers so far for the Bobcats.
Well, ODs, their girls' teams have always had great shooters. And that was kind of something they had lacked, I think, the past couple years, which was just weird to see.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they've had just dynamite shooters, even those not named Menix, where they always had a couple great shooters.
Oh, yeah.
Sarver to inbound. Lead. Drives and kicks. Baseline jumper. No good by Sarver. Offensive rebound by Bollenbacher.
That was Lead that helped tip that ball out there.
3-point try is good. And by Samantha Redinger. She's got 12, and Argos leads by 5.
Dragons able to capitalize on that offensive rebound.
Steal. No. Sarver not quite able to hold on to that.
She might have walked anyway, so Oregon Davis keeps the possession.
Thompson. Strip Sarver, foul Sarver, that'll be 2, and that was in the act of shooting. Sarah Thompson at the line for Oregon Davis. Lady Bobcats coming 5-11 on the season. First free throw's up and good.
First points for Thompson here on the evening. Pulls the Bobcats back to within 4. Speaking of 4, coming into the game for, 42. I didn't see the 2 was tucked in there. Leah Pizzuto, she's worked her way into the basically the six-man role here for the Dragons here this year, just a freshman.
Yeah, I think she's somebody who can help out with some ball handling. Oftentimes gets stuck in the front court. Redinger. Bollenbacher, 3-point try. Good by Olivia Lead. Argos by 6.
You know, that's a dimension that the Dragons have needed, and Olivia Lead has really gave Argos another shooter out there on the perimeter. You know, we talk a lot about Morgan Barkas' ability to facilitate the offense. She can hit those threes as well.
First turnover of the game by Argos, but then it's
jump ball,
so it's Argos ball. Anyway, so it's Argos gets it back. So that was a pick and pop play, and good for a while. Let's see if they run a give and go here. Well, they run that flare screen on an inbounds play. Lead kicks out. Walk on Olivia Lead. Turnover number 2 for Argos.
Krause playing really tight on Samantha right now.
That shot the Lead hit was not a 3. It was a 2, I believe. So it's 16-11, not 17.
Okay.
3-point try from the corner. Air ball by Patrick. Barkas the rebound. Morgan's a good rebounding guard. Oh, nice pass to Redinger. She misses. Rebounded by Krause, but then she double dribbles. Turnover number 5. Kraus kind of got a little indecisive there. She, again, clearly the OD girls are, they're very conscientious about making that outlet pass.
Yeah. Well, that's, again, that's just one of those things that you do at OD, right?
Yep. Bollenbacher with a short little 7-foot banker.
Four now for Ellie.
3-point try. No good by Patrick. Tipped out. Offensive rebound by Thompson. Misses. Rebounded by Lead. Lydia. Nice ball handling. Barkas. Redinger. A little pump. 3-point try. Nope.
Oh, that time Bollenbacher tipped it away. Pizzuto.
Yeah. But then there's a steal by Redinger. Up, no. Blocking foul on Thompson. That'll be her first and the team's second. And Thompson's feet were, she kind of backtracking and wasn't able to set her feet. First free throw was good by Redinger.
19-11. We have 3:02 to go here in the first period.
She hits both. 20-11. Oh, that was a close to a walk by Kraus. Knocked out by Barkas.
14 of the 20 are Samantha Redinger's points here for the Dragons.
Talk about Pizzuto. She's a freshman. I know Coach Jennings just likes his freshman class in general. Obviously, Ava Vanderweel is injured right now. Kinsley Kelly is a player with a nice potential as well. As that is Wireman, winning a 15-footer. 20-13.
Madison's first points of the evening.
3-point try. Good by Olivia
Leader. She's got five.
And driving in and drawing the foul is Kraus. Foul on Barkas.
You know, I remember Olivia back when she was in fourth and fifth grade and sixth grade. She was just as tough-nosed as she is now, but she would get a rebound, and she'd come down on her knees. I'm like, put your feet down, girl. Quit landing on your knees. You're going to be getting a knee replacement before you get out of high school. And she is as tough as they come.
Foul on Lead on the inbounds pass. That's her first and the team's fifth. So OD's in the bonus, and Sarah Thompson is at the line shooting two. I can't imagine Coach Jennings like that. First free throw is good by Thompson.
Now for Thompson. She's 2-for-3 from the line.
Misses the second. Barkas with the rebound as bounces off the floor. 23-14. Argos with the ball and a 9-point lead. 3-point try. No good by Lee. Offensive rebound. Count the goal and a foul. Samantha Redinger.
Take another look at that. Great offensive rebound there for Redinger. Good block out there by Ellie Bollenbacher as well. Really freed up Sam to get that rebound.
3-point play. Lead up to 12 now, 26-14.
And quickly down the other way, Laster cannot handle that. That's a turnover for the Bobcats.
Turnover number 7. Natalie Thompson is a 5'7 freshman, and she just checked in for Morgan Davis. That last foul was on Laster of OD, so she's got one, and the team has three. Lead advances. 3-point try. Good by Morgan Barkas. 29-14. We still got 2 minutes to go in the quarter.
Wow, yeah, 29 points. That is crazy.
3-point try. Another by Patrick. Offensive rebound by Thompson. Good hands by Barkas, but it goes right back to Thompson, who's still stuck in the corner. More good hands by Barkas. And then he was able to restart the dribble. After all that, goes off Bollenbacher's foot and goes out of bounds.
You know, 29 points, and four of the five starters for Argos have scored. So it's not just Sam getting the points here in this quarter for the Dragons.
Inbounded Wireman. Kraus, post-entry Thompson. Foul, and if that's on Bollenbacher, that'll be two. –
Yes, it is. That's the one thing, you know, neither one of these teams can afford is foul trouble. There are only two subs for Oregon Davis. And
right, especially with Sarver also in a little bit of foul trouble. And the fact that your opponent's in the bonus, though Thompson does miss the first.
Her third trip to the free throw line here. She's only 2 for 5 so far. Make it 3 for 6. She has 3 points. So Sarver's going to come back in here for Bollenbacher. You know, Bollenbacher's kind of one of those players. I mean, she plays 110% all the time, but sometimes she can pick up a foul that, you know, if she just hold back a little bit.
Right. And just trust that you stay in front of your player.
Nice
give and go. Wow. And the layup is good by Lead. No good on the other ones. That Krause, then Sarver has it stolen from her.
There's 3 on Sarver. Let's take another look here at that little give and go there with Lead finishing out that last bucket.
Yeah, you got to bump cutters. I mean, it's nice offense, but if you let anybody just sail down the lane like that, that's.
And there wasn't a lot of pressure there. Morgan was able just to make the nice easy pass. Boy, Thompson, you talk about making a limit at the free throw line. This is her fourth trip to the line here in this first quarter. 5 for.
She makes
5
both.
5 for 8 from the line.
31-17 now. Marcus, again, to Lee, Pizzuto. Kind of a little triangle set as they're trying to free Redinger from the weak side. That's a travel on Barkas.
Really, that's probably the best result you could get from that, because if it wasn't a travel, it's probably going to be a charge.
I was just going to say that was also the best defensive possession for OD. They really locked down on that weak side because that was designed to get to run Sam off a screen. They didn't let it happen. Wireman knocked out by Redinger.
So they move senior night up to tonight. They were going to do senior night on Saturday evening against Pioneer, but the threat of the weather, they don't know, you know, whether that game will be played or not, so they decided to go ahead and do senior night here tonight, make sure they got that in. Mm-hmm. Hard to believe Saturday's the last home game here for the Lady Dragons. They got Bi-County next week, and they go to LaVille after that, and they're done. That's the end of the regular season for Argos.
Lead to Pizzuto. Barkas. OD sitting back. They're playing a box. Patrick guarding Redinger and the other 4 in a zone.
You know, on the girls' side of things, Bi-County, that's going to be interesting this year. I don't really, you know, off the top of my head, you know, there's no clear favorite on the girls' side, unless you can say.
Redinger drives, misses, but she is fouled.
You got somebody in mind for Bi-County?
To win?
Yeah.
If you bet John Glenn every year. Bremen is sneaky.
Yeah.
They are sneaky.
She make the first?
She made both, 33-17. Up into Thompson, working Redinger. Foul on Redinger with 2.5 to go.
Yeah, Bremen is sneaky. They did get that. They had a big win the other night against Bethany Christian. Bethany Christian, that was the last game we did here. The Argos Lady Dragons fell just a little bit short against them. So, yeah. Bremen is sneaky, and I don't know. Glenn's good, but I don't know they're as good as they've been in the past few years. So
I like the Glenn boys. I know Triton's been getting a lot of talk, but I think the Bremen boys are sneaky also.
Yeah.
Bremen boys can really shoot it. 1 of 2 from the line from Thompson, 33-18. Barkas, can she get it off in time? No. And that is the end of the first quarter.
All right, after one, Argos 33, Oregon Davis 8. We'll take a break and come back here for second quarter action here in just a moment on RTC TV4. 33-18 here after one. Samantha Redinger, 19 points there in that first quarter, Val.
Oh, duh. The New Prairie girls are going to win the Bi-County. They've had a great year.
Oh, I forgot they were even in the Bi-County.
Yeah, we're dumb. New Prairie is going to win the Bi-County. I think they're...
Yeah, that's true. I completely forgot that they were even in the Bi-County, Val.
Yeah.
It's been a couple of years since I've been real heavy in the Bi-County action. So.
Yeah, a wise person just texted me named Jennings. Okay. Start of the second quarter, OD ball. Thompson again gets close to the rim. Patrick gets blocked by Barkas. Pizzuto comes out of there with it. Here comes Morgan Barkas in the open court to Redinger. Back to Barkas. Three-point try. No. That was strange. They face-guarded Redinger, and there were two people on her, so she just hit the open player, but Morgan misses. Patrick driving. Runner along the baseline. Tough shot. No. Knocked out by Redinger. It'll stay with the Lady Bobcats.
Sarah Thompson has 6 points for the Bobcats. She was the only one to go to the free throw line. She shot 10 free throws in that first quarter. Mm-hmm. 6 of 10.
Knocked out of bounds by a lead. Here's a scoring update. West Lafayette leads Rensselaer 27-26 at halftime.
Ooh.
Rensselaer, one of two undefeated teams left in the state, and the other team is Caston. They're playing tonight as well against Tri-County.
Yeah. Did you see the Tri-County Seeger score the other night?
It was bad for Seeger.
Yeah, they laid it on, and I mean, I was impressed with that Tri-County team. They were down at Pioneer on Saturday, but they really laid it on a really good Seeger team there two nights ago, I think.
Off that flare screen play, three pointers, good by Samantha Redinger.
22 already for Sam.
Krause runner in the lane, misses. Lead. And Laster get tied up. Redinger was down for a little while. I think the whole gym caught its breath for a second, but Sam's fine. Held ball, OD ball. Three-pointer out of the corner. No good by Patrick. Rebounded by Redinger. Redinger drops off to Barkas, who waits for the defense
nice little
to clear
step
and
through.
Misses. Rebounded by Thompson.
Is that going to be a foul on Sarver?
It is.
That is number four on Sarver.
Her fourth, team's first, yep.
Well, they're saying three on the board, but they said three on the board the last time.
I ever with four.
I do, too. We'll see if they change that.
Krause, Thompson, Laster, Patrick. There's Krause again. Pizzuto stays in front of her. Three-point try. No good by Patrick. Rebounded by Pizzuto.
Pizzuto ripping the board down there.
Nice outlet pass. Barkas to Redinger. She misses. Rebounded by Laster. Do we have a turnover? Yeah.
Yep.
Turnover number 9 for Oregon Davis. 36-18 Argos. Barkas, lead. Three-point try. No good by lead. Rebounded by Krause. Stolen by Redinger. Sam scores on that crossover move. That's kind of her patented move. Among other patented moves, as the lead is up to 20. She tried it before, missed. Made that one. Three-point try, way off by Krause, rebounded by Ellie Bollenbacher. Redinger to lead. Barkas. Trying to use a brush screen from lead to get open, but Patrick fights through that well. Now they get it back to the weak side. Three-point try. Timeout called by Argos with 5:23 to go in the half.
All right, we'll take a quick break here and be right back. back here at Phil Wainwright Gymnasium, senior night for the Argos Lady Dragons, and they are taking care of business so far here, leading 38-18. Coach Jennings didn't like what the offense was doing there, calls a timeout, his first timeout of the game. Got 5:23 left to go here in quarter number two. Marcus will inbounds there. Redinger will trigger it on the far sideline for the Dragons.
Krause is face up on Redinger as she inbounds it into the backcourt to lead. Again, they're still in a box and one, but Patrick's not the one guarding. It's now Krause, and that shot has missed. Another rebound by Thompson. Bad pass, stolen by Barkas. Pizzuto to Barkas, and she's fouled by Krause. So that's a pretty good foul, first foul of the quarter. And for Gabriella Krause, that is her first. Inbounded to Bollenbacher. She misses. But that was a nice play. And then Barkas
called for the reach in. That looked like it could have been called a jump ball there. I don't know that she really got anything but ball, but they get her for. What am I missing here? They say number three?
I have her for two.
I didn't have her for any. Did they move one of Sarver's over to Barkas, maybe?
Perhaps.
Now I'm really confused.
Lexi Gibson now in the game for Argos. She's wearing number 40.
Well, if that's three on Barkas, that's going to create a huge problem here for Argos. Still 4:44 to go in this first half.
Inbounded Patrick. Three-point try. No, it looked like a moving screen. Held ball, Argos ball, with 4:39 to go in the half.
So they're going to move Redinger over to run the point here for the time being with Barkas on the bench.
And that doesn't change the defensive strategy. Still in a box. Redinger, lead. Pizzuto, Gibson. 17-footer is no good by Lead. Rebound, Laster and Gibson. What a good play. And held ball, OD possession. 4:07.
Not much Ellie could do with that. Once she realized she got the possession, there was no outlet there. And she just kind of had to basically give up the held ball.
Thompson. It was Wireman, Patrick.
Good defense there by Gibson. Got a hand on that, knocked it out of bounds.
I've seen Lexi Gibson on the cross-country course before. So you don't have to worry about her endurance.
Right.
We played over halfway through the second quarter, and OD has not yet scored in this quarter. Three-point try, no good by Krause. And nice rebound by Leah Pizzuto.
Leah Pizzuto ripping the boards here for the Dragons.
Lead faces up. Three-point try behind the screen. No good by Redinger. Offensive rebound by Bollenbacher up. No.
That time I'd like to have seen Ellie just go straight back up with it, not put it on the floor. It kind of gave the defense some time to recover. I think she had really good position off that offensive rebound.
Nice pass by Krause to Laster, but Laster kind of didn't know where she was in relationship to the basket and tossed up an air ball. Chloe Temple, a 5'8 freshman, is now in for OD.
Coach Lady has gone all the way down to the end of her bench now.
And there's going to be a foul. I think it's going to be on OD for mowing down a screen.
Yeah.
It'll be on Jayla Patrick. Her second, team second. 3:16 to go in the half, and Argos leading by 20. Lead, three-point try. Good by Samantha Redinger.
27 for Sam.
Patrick in the post, Thompson. Post-to-post pass intended for Temple. Turnover out of bounds. That's turnover number 12 on OD.
Good idea there by the Bobcats, just not able to connect there on that cross-lane pass. And
yeah. Well, Argus's transition defense has gotten a lot better. I mean, OD was running even after made baskets in the first quarter, and now they're not getting anything out of transition. Spin move, Redinger. No. Rebounded by Wireman. Krause up ahead to Patrick. Tries a tough runner and hits.
Wow.
First points of the quarter, and took 5.5 minutes. That was a tough shot.
7 for Patrick.
I mean, the Lydia lead was back defensively. 3-point try, no good by Redinger. Krause runs down the rebound. Plays catch with Thompson, and now Krause will advance it again. Tough shot in the lane, way short, but she gets her own rebound, misses. Thompson up, no. And Ellie Bolenbacher finally controls the rebound. I have 4 rebounds for Ellie. Correction, I have 5. Pizzuto. Lead, Redinger. Whoops. Miscommunication there, and Redinger throws it out of bounds. Natalie Thompson back in. And Sarah Thompson is 43, and Natalie Thompson is 53.
You know, I was thinking about that when I was writing down these starting lineups. Oregon Davis has always had some interesting numbers. You don't see a lot of teams that have 43, 45, 51. I mean, obviously those numbers look very familiar. You've seen a lot of girls named Minix wearing those numbers over the years, but it's just, it's not your standard 10, 24, 12 numbers that you normally see.
Mm. I never thought about that before, yeah.
It's
Sarah Thompson at the line.
Yeah, imagine that, right?
Foul on Gibson.
Her 11th free throw of the evening. She's 7 for 11.
And the second, missed.
Grace Thomas in the game.
Yeah, it's Grace Thomas in there for Argus, wearing number 44. She's got Pizzuto, Gibson, and Thomas all in there along with Lead and Redinger. Gibson.
Thomas is, she's a nice player. She's going to get you some rebounds. She's going to be strong inside on the defensive side mm-hmm. of things. Not a big scorer for the Dragons.
Pizzuto, bad pass and a turnover. 41-21 Argus, OD with the ball down by 20 here.
Neither side being really stellar on scoring here in this second quarter after a 33-18 first quarter.
Argus has outscored OD 8-3 this quarter with Redinger scoring all 8. Nice little change of direction by Krause, but throws up an air ball, and it's finally tipped around. Thomas tipped it, and Gibson wound up with it. Hands off to Redinger.
Lead went down there. I think she was trying to get a charge call, but did not get the whistle.
Redinger dribbles through a thicket of OD defenders, and she's fouled by Patrick. That is 3 on Jayla Patrick, 3 on the team.
I like that, a thicket.
First free throw is up and good by Redinger. Yeah, the New Prairie girls are favorites by count up there.
I didn't even remember they were in the tournament.
43-21. New Prairie is going to be favored to win that sectional, too. Spin move. Krause hits. Nice body control by Gabriella Krause.
Her first points of the evening here for the Bobcats.
Coming up on 20 seconds to go. Bad pass by Lee that kind of slipped out of her hand. Turnover. Thompson. Nope. Offensive foul.
Good job by Redinger getting back and taking the charge. Number two on Thompson. Number three on Thompson. Boy, I'm missing a lot of fouls here.
Yep, her third, team's fourth.
So Laster will come back in here for Thompson.
So 16.7 to go. So let's say if they put Barkas back in the game. They don't. 10 seconds. Lead. Redinger, pass intended for Thomas. Wild pass. Turnover as Patrick has it. Kraus lofts it. Misses. And that is the end of the first half. A very good first half as Argos leads Oregon Davis by 20 at 43-23.
All right, we'll take a break here and total up the halftime stats and come back here and get ready for half number two from Philway Bright Gymnasium. Dragons lead 43-23 here at the half.
Yeah, again, those teams are in the same sectional. It would appear that those are they have by far the two best records in that sectional, so obviously Caston putting their undefeated record on the line against a very good Tri-County team tonight. But we've got Argos ball to start the half. Redinger, Barkas. Yeah. Flare screen, three-point try. No. Rebounded by Thompson.
The rest of the Caston schedule is kind of tough.
Well, it's more than kind of tough.
Yeah, Bethany Christian, you got Carroll coming up.
Three-point try by Patrick is no good. Kraus the rebound. No. Redinger the rebound. Flips it up on the... No, offensive rebound by Bollinger. By Bollenbacher, back up it good.
Got you too, didn't
it? Ellie, bucket at the other end. Missing the shot was Laster, rebounded by Sarver.
You did a Rochester game last night, so at least you have it a little bit more of an excuse to go the Bollenbacher or the Bollinger route.
Lead. And it's Kraus who's face guarding Redinger. They run the flare screen, the three-point try. Got it, and she is fouled.
Point number 32 with that 3-and-1 opportunity here for Samantha.
Follows on Kraus. The free throw is good. It's a four-point play. The lead's up to 26 now.
33 for Sam.
Thompson puts it on the deck, misses, and puts back in her own miss.
First field goal for Thompson. She has 10 points, but that was her first field goal.
Well, she's a mobile big. Three-point try. Good by Leading up long two-pointer.
Yeah, a couple of those right there. That's one of those things that Coach Jennings, you know, hopefully Lydia can kind of pick up on. And there's a steal. Lead picks that right out.
Three on one. Redinger, layup is good.
Great job leading that break there by Lydia Lead, and a nice bounce pass over to Sam for the bucket.
That's your pun, not mine. Leading.
Oh,
leading
I
the
wasn't,
break.
See, I wasn't even thinking that. I was just going with the call there. Sorry.
If she had committed a turnover, it would be misleading. Okay, there's my pun.
Okay.
I said Teen Wolf last night. Because Logan Sport had a girl named Wolf.
Oh, okay.
Barkas at the top of the key. Bollenbacher, mid-range 15-footer. Nope, she gets her own rebound. Puts it back up. No. Offensive rebound by Redinger. Goes glass and scores.
How is that not an and one? I mean, she got knocked to her butt on that one.
30-point lead. Three-point try. Good by Kraus.
Five for Kraus.
Lead brings it up. Barkas, baseline, jumper. Way out by Redinger. Kraus the rebound.
Bollenbacher.
Kraus misses, rebounded by Barkas. Bollenbacher kind of fell down and wasn't paying attention. They needed to bring the ball up the court. Barkas.
Not sure why Morgan picked up her dribble there.
Yeah. Lead. Have a little weave handoff to Barkas Sarver. Lead. Good defense by Thompson. Turnover. Kraus. Runner in the lane. Nope, but she's fouled.
Is that Gabriel on Sarver? Four on Sarver.
Yes.
Rough senior night here for Alicia Sarver. She's been saddled with foul trouble all night long. Picks up number four with 4:26 to go here in the third period.
First free throw by Kraus is good.
First free throw on the for the Bobcats by somebody not named Thompson here tonight.
Well, what must it be like to be a point guard and your assistant coach is Lexi Minix? I mean, who played point guard not only at OD but at Marquette. Not Marquette Catholic, like Marquette, the one in Milwaukee. Bollenbacher will push it up. Three-point try. No good by Redinger. Pizzuto and Kraus battling for it and winds up in Leeds' hands in the corner. Barkas to a cutting Redinger who lays it in. 57-30. Kraus in the lane hits.
10 for Redinger here in this quarter alone. 39 now for the game.
Yeah, 50 is in danger. Pizzuto baseline jumper. In and out, no.
Well, she's three away from a pretty hefty mark here.
Natalie Thompson now in.
I'm assuming that's a Courtney Dunlap record.
I'm assuming.
I think that she held that record her senior year.
Give and go play. Three-point try. Short by Kraus. Good rebound by Thompson. Thompson gets rebounds even if, you know, I mean, you have to box her out. You can't just stand in front of her.
You know, this is just the first meeting between these two teams this year. They could meet two more times possibly if the stars align for them in the bi-county and then possibly sectional.
Mm-hmm. Three-point try. No by Redinger. Bollenbacher gets on the floor. Held ball, OD ball, with 3:06 to go in the quarter. And that was right on the money in terms of the execution. It just didn't go in the basket by Samantha. Kraus. Looks somebody got a hand on that, able to strip her. That's another held ball. Turnover OD, Argus ball with 2:56 to go in the quarter. 16 turnovers for OD. Barkas to Pizzuto as Argus breaks the press. Pizzuto's jumper is no good. Oh, what an effort by Bollenbacher. Three-point try. No, another offensive rebound by Bollenbacher. Ellie puts it back up and in. 27-point lead.
Eight now for Ellie.
That's just hard work.
Yeah, I mean, that's what you get from Ellie. She's going to clean up the boards for you.
Held ball, OD ball on the arrow. 2:25 to go in the quarter.
Not afraid to set screens, clean up the rebounds, and do all the dirty work as Ellie Bollenbacher for the Lady Dragons.
Temple back in. Thompson.
Boy.
Kicks it back out to Patrick. Three-point try by Kraus. She misses. Morgan Barkas gets it. Redinger up ahead to Pizzuto. She traveled.
Not sure what Thompson was doing down there. I mean, she turned around and went back to the free throw line like she was going to go the other way. I mean, she had position on the defender there. I think she was in front of lead. Looked like an easy bucket, but Bobcats not able to capitalize.
Kraus. Patrick. And stepping in front of the post-entry pass was lead. Turnover. Barkas. Pizzuto.
You see what hand she used to knock that away?
Her left?
No, her lead hand.
Her lead hand, yeah.
Gotcha.
Well, there you go. Well, darn. Three-point try. No good by Redinger. Wow, that's as open a shot as she's had all night. Good pass by Lead. Kraus. Little crossover move, and her floater in the lane is in and out. Lead able to
rebound from her back.
Yeah.
Able to get the rebound and the outlet pass. That's a nice play.
Barkas, three-point try. No good by Lead. Rebounded by Temple. Kraus, long pass ahead. Finds its way into Patrick's hands. Good defense by Bollenbacher. Last touch by OD. It'll be Argus ball with 55.5 seconds to go in the quarter. Sub coming in. Laster will enter for Wireman.
Well, definitely a frenetic pace. It sure does feel like an Oregon Davis game.
Pizzuto helps out Lead, who will walk it up. Barkas, Redinger, Lead. Pass fake. Kick back out. 35 seconds to go in the quarter. Barkas and Redinger playing catch on the volleyball line. Lead. Bollenbacher.
Nice drop step. Oh, wish she could have finished that.
Yeah.
That was a really good drop step.
Kraus with another runner in the lane, and that goes. Kraus has just had a little kind of crossover move.
9.25 here for Kraus.
Bad pass, turnover. Laster with the steal. Kraus again. Stripped by Lead. Loose, turnover. End of the quarter.
All right, after three, it is Argus 59, Oregon Davis 34. We'll take a break. Come back and get ready for fourth quarter action here from Phil Wainwright Gymnasium in just a moment here on RTC TV4.
Rebounded to Barkas. Hand off to Lead. Bad pass. That's a turnover. Sarah Thompson with the steal. Kraus, long pass up ahead. Redinger.
Oh, yeah, I think he made that, yeah.
Touched out of bounds. Foot touched out of bounds on the catch. It'll be OD ball on the baseline. That's one way to advance it. Tri-County leads Caston 16-5 in the first quarter.
Say that again.
Tri-County leads Caston 16-5 in the first quarter. Steal by Bollenbacher. Back comes Barkas. She gets a foot in the lane. Pizzuto. Trailer is Lead. Three-point try. Good by Samantha Redinger. Good ball movement there.
And that should be the record, Val. If I got my information correctly, 51, Patrick with a three.
It's Patrick with a three, 62-37.
42 points for Samantha Redinger.
Timeout Argus as Barkas was caught along the corner. 7:06 to go in the game. It's going to be a 30.
All right, we'll take a quick one here with him. All right, 7:06 to go here in the game, 62-37. Dragons ball here. Redinger will take it on the near sideline.
And the Barkas back to Redinger along the sideline. They run a couple defenders at her, but she's able to swing it over to Lead. Bollenbacher.
Single game record.
Three-point try is good by Samantha Redinger.
Sam's five away from her own single-game record of 50 that she's hit twice this year. Still 6:44 to go here in the ball game.
Kraus is fouled. That'll be on Bollenbacher. Gabriella Kraus will shoot two. First free throw is good.
Three for three from the line for Kraus. 12 points for Kraus. Misses the second.
Thompson the rebound, and that's going to be a foul on Bollenbacher.
Yeah, that was definitely a foul. I have her for four. Yep. So Sarver and Bollenbacher with four, Barkas with three.
Three-point try, Wireman. That shot was flat. Offensive rebound by Thompson. Puts the ball on the deck and misses, rebounded by Sarver. Passes immediately, stolen by Kraus. Thompson misses on the putback. She gets another offensive rebound. And the basket's good. That's Kraus. 65-40.
How many short shots did Oregon Davis miss on that with good offensive rebounds? We're just not able to put that one in.
Oh, she Sarver, missed Bollenbacher. Pass deflected by Patrick. Turnover.
Marcus getting a little sloppy with their passing, trying to throw those overhead passes, and Oregon Davis is really keen on that.
Thompson, Kraus, Wireman, it's Patrick for three. Nope.
Good block out by Redinger.
Redinger on the push. To a trailing Barkas. Back to Redinger.
Nice fake. Too easy off of that fake. She just goes in for the layup. 47 now for Sam.
Runner by Kraus is no good. Rebounded by Sarver.
Kind of has that feel of one of those Sunday afternoons where you're playing pickup ball and you're at the end of the day. Nobody really wants to play defense.
Three-point try, no good by Redinger. Rebounded by Wireman. Strip by Redinger. That should have been a foul on OD, even though Sam is even shocked by that. Technical foul.
Is that on Jennings or Lady?
Okay. Correction, that's a technical foul on OD, I guess, on the bench. So, Samantha Redinger is at the line for two. She's already scored 47 points in this game. Misses that.
She missed them both.
Full timeout taken by Oregon Davis.
All right, we'll take a break with them here and be back in just a moment. Now by Oregon Davis, the two technical free throws by Argos.
And I'm sorry, when the official pointed, I thought he pointed at the Argos bench. I thought he said the technical was on Argos. Actually, it was on OD. And I didn't see Redinger attempt the first free throw. I saw her miss the second, but she wound up missing both. Redinger with a pass to Sarver. Bollenbacher. Dangerous pass, but it gets to Barkas. Kicks out. Three-point try. In and out by Redinger. Last touch by Sarver out of bounds. ...22-8 Tri-County over Caston at the end of the first quarter. Deflected by Bollenbacher. Turnover. Redinger drops
nice
it off
pass.
To Bollinger. Layup is good.
Boy, that was beautiful. Ten now for Bollenbacher.
Thompson with a runner down the lane. She misses. She gets another offensive rebound. She gets another offensive rebound. Knocked out of her hands at Kraus's 15-footer is good.
Boy, Thompson's going to have some major offensive rebound stats, but she's just not able to put that ball in right now.
Another turnover. Kraus. Maybe a foul on lead. 4:01 to go. Free throws up and good by Gabriella Kraus. the second. Misses. Thompson, another offensive rebound.
Wow.
That's her eighth rebound this half. Kraus runner, no. Barkas comes out of that. Argus should have numbers. Lee misses a short banker and a one-on-zero, but Sarver grabs the offensive rebound.
Well, just one little dribble there. Lee would have had an easy layup.
Redinger. Good hustle by Kraus. That's a turnover. Ooh. Kraus and Barkas collide. That'll be a foul on Barkas.
I mean, number four on Morgan. Number four on the team, so Morgan Davis will be, is that four or five? They're lining up like it's five. Nope,
I have
here.
Four.
Yeah. So next free throw here, Morgan Davis will be shooting the bonus the rest of the way. Still 3:27 to go here in this game.
Thompson.
That's going to be it on Ellie Bollenbacher.
Not continuation, so it'll be bonus.
It'll still be two, yeah.
It'll be two free throws because it's bonus. But Ellie Bollenbacher's fouled out.
So Ellie fouls out with 3:23 to go. 10 points for Ellie. That's Thompson's first free throws here in the second half. She mm-hmm. was 8 for 12 in that first half.
Well, if you get as many offensive rebounds as she does, the free throws will follow.
10 for 14. She's got 12 points, one field goal.
Lead. Beats the pressure single-handedly, and then she is fouled. That'll be second foul of the quarter. It'll be on Wireman.
That is the first foul on Madison Wireman. So a long way to go here before Argus gets into the bonus. Only the second team foul on the Bobcats.
Pizzuto. Three-point try. Good
ties
by
it.
Samantha Redinger. She's got 50.
Ties her record for the third time this season, 50 points in a ball game. That's just crazy.
Patrick's three Ooh. Is good. Timeout.
That is her second.
Full timeout taken by Oregon Davis with a minute. We'll get you the time later. The 72-48 Argus.
Yeah, it gets you, doesn't it? That clock with the timer on there. We'll be right back. 2:55 to go here as we get back here in play with the Argus Dragons leading 72-48.
Argus still OD still pressing full court. Barkas comes back and helps out lead.
That's Pizzuto there.
Excuse me, Pizzuto, and then yeah. Pizzuto travels. Pizzuto, Barkas, lead, Redinger, Sarver, the five on the floor for Argus. Kraus, Wireman, Sarah Thompson, Patrick, and Laster, the five on the floor for Oregon Davis. Patrick, three-point try. She hits.
That is number four for Patrick from the three-point line. Three.
Just kind of a driving kick play.
Yeah. She's got three here in this quarter alone.
Barkas. Dangerous pass, but it winds up in Leeds' hands. Three-point try. Short by Redinger. And there is Laster on the break. Misses. Offensive rebound by Kraus. No, but she's fouled.
Pizzuto, I believe. Yep. Maybe Leah's first.
Well, this is why Bollenbacher's foul problems are just a big concern, because Argus isn't a tremendous rebounding team even with Bollenbacher, and they have given up a ton of offensive rebound in this game. We saw them play that game against Northwestern.
Oh, my, yeah. I mean, this isn't even a really tall Oregon Davis team either.
Yeah, and Northwestern grabbed every rebound in that game, and that's part of the reason why they came back. So Kraus goes 1-for-2. It's a 20-point lead. Ball slips out of Redinger's hand. She's just able to get it off to Sarver to preserve the possession. Lead. Barkas. Pass fake lead. Behind the screen. 3-point try. Good again. 53. A school record. on senior night. Amazing.
Broke her own record here tonight, 53 points, and we still have a minute 50 to go.
The runner in the lane is good by Sarah Thompson, 75 to 54. Nice little ball handling by Sarver to get out of trouble. Redinger.
Nice
pass to lead. Foul on Sarah Thompson.
Number four on Thompson. Lydia lead. First time here at the free throw line for the junior, and she puts the first one in. Got her with 10 now as well.
She hits one of two. Rebounded by Laster. Up ahead to Thompson.
Oh, she traveled, yeah.
Traveled. Turnover number 22 for Oregon Davis. 17 for Argos. I'd be curious to know what OD's turnovers are per game. Given this style, there's just a lot more possessions in the game. So maybe they have a lot more turnovers, but they're also, you know, maybe efficient. Air ball by Redinger. Rebounded by Patrick Kraus. Pass deflected by Lead, but goes right back to Kraus. And then Barkas with the steal. And then that's a turnover. Thompson misses. Lead. Up ahead to Sarver. Lead to Redinger. Barkas penetrates, throws it up off the rim. No, but she's fouled by Laster. With 50.6 seconds to go. First free throw is good by Barkas.
4 points for Barkas.
53 points on senior night against maybe your biggest rival, one of your biggest rivals. One for two.
Oh, I think it's the biggest two or three rivals for Argos.
Yeah.
I mean, Oregon Davis and Argos, that's,
yep,
that's as big as they get.
Wireman, three-point try. No good. Rebounded by Redinger. 30 seconds. Redinger to lead. Lead circling around with the dribble. Pizzuto. Barkas. Final 10 seconds. Redinger penetrating. Layup is good. 55 will be the number in the books. And she outscored OD by one at the end.
Oh, my gosh. Wow.
Argos beats Oregon Davis 79 to 54.
Hey, a good win for the Dragons tonight. Kudos to Oregon Davis. They came out and battled us hard tonight. It was a good win for us. I wanted to make this night a little bit special for these two. This is my fourth year coaching. These two have been with me for the whole 4 years. They come on as freshmen, my first year. I'm going to call them Sam and Gail tonight, other than Samantha and Alicia, because I don't know any better. So when I refer to them, it's going to be Sam and Gail. This is the last time they'll play on this home court, maybe. We might get Pioneer in Saturday, we might get it in next week, but we want to do senior night just in case. Last time they play here, it's the last time I get to address our crowd, maybe a little bit on behalf of them. I want their senior night to be a little bit special for them. So I'm going to talk about these two for a little bit, and I've got some other people I want to introduce. Like I said, 3 years ago, I got the job, I think, in July, so I didn't have much of a summer with these guys. And it was the COVID year, and everybody's wearing masks, and it was crazy. And the first couple weeks of practice, I thought these two were twins. They looked alike, they're wearing masks, all I could see was their eyes, they act alike, they hang out together, they were inseparable. They still are. But what I like most about these two is they encouraged each other, they held each other accountable for 4 years. You know, I think Gail's been a huge part of Sam's success and vice versa. Gail spent 3 years playing JV. She had some pretty good players ahead of her. You know, there were some good post players. She stepped up into a starting role this year, and that's huge. To stick with the program for 3 years playing JV ball and then go to a starter, she's done remarkable this year. They've both been good for each other through the ups and downs. They've both been there for each other, and I appreciate that out of both of them. So, that being said, I had some history lined up for Saturday night. I had a lot of girls coming back. I've got a few of them here tonight. I'm sure there's some that I didn't see sneak in yet, and hopefully they make their appearance here in a little bit. But the girls that have played with these two the last 3 years, I'm going to read their names off because they had a big role in what these two have accomplished. So Maddie Vanderbilt, Sydney Shepherd, they were the seniors when these guys were freshmen. Allison Zahn, Carly Miller, Sophia Bullenbacher, Lizzie Edmonds, they were the juniors. And then last year, our seniors that graduated were Kayla Moore, Bailey Bigley, Emma Dunlap, and Bella Stoltz. Along with this year's team, those 10 players have helped shape and contribute to Sam and Gail's success. Okay, I'm gonna have to go with the reading glasses now. Let's talk a little basketball history from Argos. I'm gonna go clear back to 1977, 78, 78, 79 season. Here's a few names I'm gonna throw out there, and unless you're 50 years old or older, you may not recognize these names. I know most of them because I was either junior high or a freshman in high school when this was taking place. Mitch Gordon, she's Chamberlain now, but Mitch Gordon, Lisa Eric, Judy Keller, Kim Hewer Odell, Holly Montgomery, Sally Thompson, Kathy Metzger Odell, Roberta Thompson. Those are just a few, and I know I left some darn good players off that list. But those names kind of stood out to me. And back in 78, 79, as good as the boys' teams and Coach Waybright's teams were, these girls were tough and they were fun to watch. Like I said, I was a freshman during that 78, 79 season. These girls' teams really didn't have any role model players to follow. The first girls' state championship was 1976 when Warsaw and Miss Basketball Judy Warren won a state championship. These girls were playing then. So you talk 1976 to 1979, this group of girls was in their prime playing. But they set the standard and set records for the future of girls basketball at Argos. 45 years ago in 1979, a sharp shooting guard, Roberta Thompson, we called her Bert, set the single game scoring record of 48 points. Ironically, it was against Oregon Davis. And Bert, I know you're here, I saw you sneak in a little bit ago. I hate to tell you this, but I had players ask if you were still alive. But there have been others. 77, 78 year, Kathy Metzger O'Dell scored 39 points against the Culver Girls Academy. Sally Thompson, Bert's older sister in 77, 78 scored 30 points against Knox. These girls were putting up some numbers from back then. So let's talk a little bit about Bert Thompson. 78, 79, she averaged 29 points a game, scoring 435 points in only 15 games. She did this with no three-point line, and I believe they used a boys-sized basketball back then. She played only 46 games in her career. Their season was shorter back then. In fact, most of the girls' basketball team were cheerleaders for the boys' team. Yeah. So she played only 46 games, scoring a career total of 758 points. That's like two seasons now. I also know from her coach that their team put up a school record, 92 points against Knox, which is still a school record. She was coached by none other than Argos legend Coach Snyder. Okay, this is going to mess me up here a little bit. History was made on November 17, 23. I believe it was made again tonight. I haven't looked at the book, but I believe it was made again tonight. As Samantha Redding and her teammates on November 17 put on a basketball performance against Trinity Greenlawn. Sam had 47 points in the game the week before. We thought she broke the record then. That night on November 17, she put on a shooting clinic, going 9 for 16 from 3-point line, 3 for 3 from the foul line, and ended with 50 points. How many did she have tonight?
55
points tonight. So that night, though, against Trinity, not only did she score 50 points, but she had 9 rebounds, 4 assists, 6 steals to go with it. That's a pretty darn good game. But Sam will be the first to tell you that her teammates sitting over here are the ones that get her the ball, they screen for her, and any 1,000-point scorer in their career does not do that alone. It's a team effort, and the team has to buy into it, and this year's team's bought into it pretty darn well. Tonight, Bert Thompson is back with us, and I would like for her and Coach Snyder, to present Sam with a basketball to honor her achievement and for breaking a 45-year-old record and for setting the goals and standards for future girls at Argos. Come on down and present that basketball. Bert, I would get up, but I'd lose my place right here. Sam, give her a hug for me. Yes. Here's Mr. Snyder, her coach. You guys presented the ball. A 45-year-old record. Records are meant to be broke, but what an achievement from Bert Thompson. Thanks for making the trip. Thanks, Mr. Snyder. Sam's first start, her freshman year, was late in the season against Pioneer. It was at Pioneer. They had a really good team. I put Sam in only for a defensive stopper. She hadn't played a whole lot of varsity that year. I didn't care if she started or if she scored that night. I put her in. They had a girl by the name of Haley Pryke that was averaging over 20 points a game. And that night, Sam held her to 9 points. I think Sam scored 11 points with her Gardner. That Pioneer team went on to win the state championship that year, and we competed hard with them for 3 quarters. I was pretty proud of her that night, but I had no idea what her accomplishments were going to be later on. Like I said, to score 1,000 points does not happen on your own. It takes remarkable teammates willing to set screens, dish out a ball, play unselfish basketball. Sam gives her team quite a bit of credit. Again, Sam made history on December 21st with a 31-point performance against Bethany Christian to go over the 1,000 career point milestone. She became only the 6th player in Argos history to join the elite club. In the 2001-2002 season, Jenny Emanaker became Argos' first 1,000-point scorer. 24 points her senior year, averaging over 21 points a game. She put up a game, 38 points against Marquette in her junior year, 38 against South Central her senior year, as well as 32 and 30 against River Forest and Trinity. She played through a lot of bad knee injuries and ended her career with 1,126 points, which was the record for the next 5 years. Jenny was coached by Rochester's Indiana All-Star and Indiana State University great Shelley Newell. I'm going to come back to Jenny in just a little bit. The 2006-2007 season saw two more players pass the 1,000-point mark. Desiree Gilbert, 1,130 career points. Amberly Odell, 1,510 career points that year. Both went on to have stellar college careers, and both were also coached by Coach Shelley Newell. Amberly Odell then held the career scoring record. Another teammate of Amberly and Desiree became the fourth player in the 2008-2009 season to pass 1,000 points. A little bit of talent in that pool right then. Kelsey Holleball finished her career with 1,332 points, coached by Shelley Newell. Kelsey was hoping to be here tonight, but is given back tonight as she coaches her 8th grade girls in Indianapolis. The 2016-17 season adds the 5th 1,000-point score. Courtney Dunlap became Argos' all-time scorer with 1,527 career points for her 4-year career. That is a pretty high mark that will take a player with a lot of drive and dedication that she competed with. Courtney was coached by Coach Gary Teal and assistant coach, Coach Snyder. Sam, I'm very humbled to have coached you for all 4 years and watched all 1,000-plus points go through the hoop, and for you to become the 6th Argos 1,000-point scorer. At this time, I would like to ask Jenny Emanaker, the first 1,000-point scorer, and Shelley Newell, if she's here, she was going to try to come, I don't know if she made it, which was her coach, to present Sam with her 1,000-point ball. Jenny. Still, what a great night for you guys. Thank you.